On tonight's CTV News, peeping toms are causing trouble in North Canterbury, roadworks are leaving a local dairy owner stranded, and one of Canterbury's first same-sex couples to tie the knot are celebrating their first year anniversary. This is CTV News. I'm Grant Mangan. A North Canterbury swimming pool is tightening security.
Clamping down on peeping toms, North Canterbury's Dudley Pool is now checking changing rooms every 3 hours.
We think it's relatively small in terms of it being a problem, and this is really just about us trying to take some preventative actions and be safe around that stuff.
The Waimakariri District Council introduced the changing room sweeps as part of a new safety and security policy.
They're not specifically looking for cell phones or looking for any sort of hidden devices. All they're doing is looking for belongings, usually bags or those kinds of things that have just been left in the change rooms.
The policy follows an increase in reports of covert filming using anything from mobile phones to cameras disguised as pens. The Christchurch Police Intelligence Group's concerns are noted in the Waimakariri Council's Community and Recreation Committee report. More than 1 million swimmers have walked through these doors, with only one incident reported. Aquatic Facilities Manager Simon Hart believes it's a prevention method.
It's not necessarily something that's new for the aquatic facilities across the country. The concept of having cell phones that have recording devices on them has been in the front of our minds for some time, but we're just conscious of it.
Christchurch City and Selwyn Councils have banned the use of any video or cameras, including phones in changing rooms, which means swimmers will be taking note of more of these signs.
As well, if people leave their belongings in these areas, it could become tempting for people to come in there and just pick those things up and take them away. So
the press reports that Ministry of Justice figures show the number of people charged with the intimate covert filming offence has been steadily increasing since legislation took effect in December 2006. Emma Cropper, CTV News.
Canterbury is the leading region in farm sales. More than 1,900 farms changed hands in the past year, according to the Real Estate Institute. Farm sales are up 25% over the last year nationwide, although winter has seen sales of dairy farms reduce by 50%. Sales of lifestyle properties fell by more than 13%. A year ago today, 31 same-sex couples married in New Zealand. Since then, almost 900 other couples have joined them. CTV News was there to see two women tie the knot, and this morning, Marcus Gibbs caught up with them as they celebrated their first wedding anniversary.
It was the moment they'd been planning for 3 years. A kiss sealed the deal. Kim and Vicky becoming Mrs. and Mrs. Irvine Ernie 1 year ago today.
It's gone by really fast, but yeah, couldn't be happier. It's, yeah, fantastic.
Last year at their wedding, the couple was very thankful for the 77 politicians who voted to legalise same-sex marriage. In April 2013, the bill passed its third reading, and there were hugs, tears and cheers in front of a crowded public gallery.
We could legally get married. You know, it was the most happiest day of my life. I guess in all honesty, it is true love. There's just nothing that's ever going to come between us, you know. I just wish everybody had what we had.
Since they tied the knot, the Irvine Ernies have had a blissful marriage. Not even one fight. Despite some of the negativity around same-sex marriage, no one has criticised their love.
Yeah, I've never been, you know, this happy. It's wonderful. I'm with the person I love, you know, and it's really good.
When Kim was growing up, same-sex relationships were frowned upon. But as society became more open, so did Kim.
Something that I never thought would ever happen to me, but, you know, life is unpredictable, and now look, you know, I'm happily married. We've been together for 4 years now.
The couple have four children between them from previous relationships. They didn't have a honeymoon, so the whole family went to Hanmon last weekend to celebrate a year of happy marriage.
First time we've been away in our four-year relationship, so yeah, it was nice to get away.
Kim and Vicky are looking forward to spending the rest of their life together as a happily married couple. Marcus Gibbs, CTV News.
Well, 1 year on from the law change, Marcus Gibbs went out onto the streets to see what locals think now about same-sex marriage.
I don't know how I feel about it.
You're not too sure about it?
Well, I wasn't at the time, but it's okay.
It's okay?
Yeah. Worst things are happening in the world.
I don't really mind. I don't care, you know. Well, I haven't really paid it any attention, but not concerned about it. It's all good, yeah.
I think it turned out pretty well. I'm nothing against same-sex marriage.
I think it's something that hasn't been before time. I mean, everybody has their own feelings, their own love of each other, and if they can celebrate by same-sex marriage, well, good luck to them.
Oh, yeah. Personally, I'm not so agree with this.
You're not very happy about it?
Yes, yes.
And why is that?
Maybe culture, religion, yeah, so.
Nah, like I'm pretty easy. I mean, I think good on them myself.
There were people who were worried about this happening. They said the world's going to end. This is going to be terrible for the country.
Well, I don't think that's happened, obviously.
I think there'll be a lot more happy people because of it.
Well, coming up, a local dairy owner is not so happy. He's feeling stranded by roadworks.
Meet the latest arrivals at Berlin's two animal parks and find out what it takes to be a zoo baby in a modern zoo. Zoo Juniors. Wednesday nights at 8 p.m. right here on CTV.
Yuck, look at all this moss and lichen. I'm not getting up there, not in these heels. Time to call Mossbuster.
Mossbuster is a no-bleach, non-abrasive, biodegradable solution that has over 35 years of proven results. You can buy Mossbuster online for less than half the cost of other well-known products and can be yours for less than a dollar a litre. You just spray it on and let Mother Nature do the rest, or Mossbuster can do it for you. Check out our website or call the Mossbuster crew for a free quote. Mossbuster, 0800 88 1000.
My son's helped me greatly with my independence now that I've got more mobility.
Mum, I've been looking into stand assist chairs from More Mobility. They recline back with a footrest, then when you want to get out of them, they stand you up. You can even sleep on them. More Mobility can bring one out for a free trial. There's even electric beds too. What do you think? For more range and more expert advice, see More Mobility, corner Clarence and Princess Streets off Blenheim Road.
What a difference More Mobility makes.
Action Removals, offering short or long-term storage facilities, full packing services, comprehensive rates, all fully insured and with 6 vehicle sizes to choose from. Earthquake repairs? Action Removals pack, move, store and return your valuable possessions stress-free. Action Removals, a family business that has been operating in Christchurch for over 10 years. Action Removals, your one-stop removal service, on time, every time. 0800 222 526.
Warm yourself up with a delicious wintry meal at Hinton's Restaurant and Vineyard. Let the flavours of the country linger in your mouth long after your plates and glasses have been cleared. Enjoy an afternoon of comfort and class with great people. Hinton's Restaurant and Vineyard.
Al Jazeera News. International news right off the satellite, bringing you up-to-the-minute coverage of world events. Al Jazeera News. Weekday mornings at 6 o'clock. Right here on CTV.
The national government has committed $100 million in new funding for cycleways, accelerating completion dates in the urban centres.
The national government's next move to fix the cycling infrastructure. Announced by Prime Minister John Key yesterday, the new funding is on top of the already $30 million spent on walking and cycling projects out of the National Land Transport Fund. $100 million in new funding out of the Crown's Consolidation Fund will be spread over the next 4 years. Building on the plans of the local councils, the money is hoped to accelerate the completion and make them more accessible. Transport Minister Jerry Brownlee says the aim is to get more people commuting by bike for the health benefits and to alleviate pressure on the transport networks. Minister Brownlee says four potential cyclists' safety risks are the biggest roadblock. He believes this new funding will build good quality infrastructure, which the national government hopes will become a real incentive for those hesitant to get back on the bike. An urban cycle investment panel will be put together, looking at ways the funding can improve the networks. AA's General Manager of Motoring Affairs, Mike Noon, says there are many concerns the cycleways are currently not well joined up. Getting cycleways built is no easy task, and Mike Noon believes the panel is a practical step to get plans moving along quickly. The draft terms will be presented to the Cabinet by the 31st of October.
People involved in promoting alcohol reforms aren't surprised about being targets of negative attacks, as revealed in Nikki Haga's controversial Dirty Politics book.
A prominent alcohol addiction expert isn't surprised by allegations of smears made against him. Nikki Haga's Dirty Politics book claims an involvement between whale oil blogger Cameron Slater and political and commercial interests to undermine opponents. The book alleges Catherine Rich of the Food and Grocery Council paid for derogatory attacks on public health advocates, including Professor Doug Salmon, a medical spokesperson of Alcohol Action New Zealand. Professor Salmon says it's exactly the sort of secret industry he's been warned about from the outset of the Alcohol Action Reform campaign 5 years ago. The book suggests Catherine arranges articles with titles slamming Professor Salmon. The book suggests an intermediary person is paid to pass information on to Cameron Slater, who posts the article on the Whale Oil blog for a fee. Former leader of the Student Volunteer Army says the underhand tricks exposed in the Dirty Politics book have left him revolted. Sam Johnson believes the dirty games and tricks need to be cleaned up, especially while campaigns are being promoted to get young people to vote.
The Ministry of Awesome has appointed their first Chief Awesome Officer. Joelle Bautista caught up with her after the announcement.
Meet Lauren Merritt, the latest addition to Christchurch's Ministry of Awesome. Excited to get stuck in and working, Lauren is excited to soon be in her new role as the Chief Awesome Officer.
I just can't wait to get there and jump in, learn about it, and then expand the Ministry of Awesome to be even more awesome.
Kyla Colvin, who founded the Ministry of Awesome, says they are equally excited to have her.
Look, we could not be happier to have Lauren on board. She is just a totally stellar human being in every way, and she has this phenomenal range of experiences that we feel are just, it's just going to bring such a freshness and a joy and a vast kind of breadth to the work that we do at Ministry of Awesome, so we're delighted.
Lauren Merritt has spent 10 years travelling and working around the globe, doing her part to make a difference.
I've spent the better part of the past 10 years travelling around the world, just experiencing cultures, experiencing people, and just learning and traveling that way. So I've traveled to Central Africa and studied there, working with child soldiers and really assessing international and local response to conflict.
Star Jam is an organisation which gives young people with disabilities the chance to experience the thrill of performing. Lauren began it down here in Christchurch, and although she will be sad to go, she's pleased to see it thriving and is excited about what lies ahead. Determined to not see the city as a broken and desolate place, this enthusiastic get-goer believes Christchurch is a place of opportunity.
I see Christchurch as, you know, a mix of a blank canvas as well as an already thriving community. So it's really just about bringing something new to it. What's missing? What can we create here? You know, we have a whole community of people with amazing ideas and people that want to support amazing ideas. So it's really just connecting them and seeing those projects come alive in the community.
Lauren came across the Ministry of Awesome by word of mouth and their weekly event, Coffee and Jam, a place for people to share their startup ideas. As Chief Awesome Officer at the Ministry of Awesome, Lauren is excited about what her new role will entail.
Really directing the organization in a way that it's going to become going to be sustainable. Just increasing visibility so that everybody knows about it, whether it's somebody out in the country north or they're a city person. They know that this is the place to go.
Encouraging others to get involved and make a difference, Lauren just wants to do what she can with the Ministry of Awesome to contribute ideas and make a difference. Joelle Bautista, CTV News.
A new Brighton dairy owner is worried he'll lose his business because of drawn-out earthquake repairs. After 3 years of constant work, another three-week closure could be the last straw. Marcus Gibbs reports.
The dairy's busy today, but tomorrow it could be a different story. Workers are moving into Keys Road, the roundabout will be blocked off, and this local dairy will be isolated for at least the next 3 weeks of roadworks. After 3 years of on and off work at the roundabout, the local dairy owner, Sammy Zhu, is worried about whether his business will still be around when the road finally reopens.
Oh, it's very hard for the last 3 years.
Tomorrow won't be the first time that skirt teams have worked to fix the roundabout. Sammy Zhu says having his road shut off hasn't been good for business. He's struggled to make a profit since the earthquakes.
I'm struggling to survive here for 3 years. I don't know how long I can still stand here.
Across the road, Anne Williamson says her business, Frame and Copy, has also taken a hit.
Yes, they're expecting to have the road closed again for another 3 weeks. We're hoping that it will just be 3 weeks because we have in the past had a period of 12 months where we had no through traffic.
It hasn't been easy for Anne to try and run a business when the road is closed for repairs.
The last 3 years have been the hardest 3 years that we've had here in the last 8 years that we've been here. We're just lucky that we are based on the east side and people in New Brighton are very supportive and they do support local business.
To survive, her business has had to adapt. It now takes a lot of phone and email orders. However, the dairy relies on foot traffic, and Anne can see Sammy is struggling.
I take my hat off to him. I don't know how he's managed to, stay there and continue in business for as long as he had.
No one from Skirt was available for an interview on camera. However, in a statement, Skirt General Manager Duncan Gibb says the two businesses have both agreed that 3 weeks of closure at the intersection was better than 11 weeks of on and off closures. Duncan Gibb is acknowledging the large amount of work at the intersection in the past 2 years. However, he says, given the placement and alignment of pipes, it is unavoidable that several projects had to occur to get wastewater pipes and other services repaired. Despite the frustrations of not having her road open, Anne agrees that this work needs to happen.
They're only doing a job and they, dig and then they find problems. They encounter things along the way that they might not have allowed for and it takes longer.
Both businesses are looking forward to when the roundabout reopens in 3 weeks' time.
Will this be the last time?
Fingers crossed. We're hoping that so.
Marcus Gibbs, CTV News.
Still to come, your regional weather.
G'day, this is Fletch, your presenter of the TV show Classic Restos. It's the show where it's your chance to see completed restorations being shown, driven, and enjoyed.
Hi, I'm Mark, and welcome to Stay Well Pharmacy. Whatever the season, Stay Well Pharmacy has you covered. As an integrated pharmacy, we stock all the well-known pharmacy medicines, as well as quality nutritional and herbal treatments. Our team of pharmacists and full-time naturopath are here to help you find the products and advice to suit the needs of you and your family. So come in and see us at Stay Well Pharmacy, 27 Shands Road in Hornby. Stay Well Pharmacy. Live well. Stay well.
Come in and meet the locals at the Bush Inn Centre. Whether it's to grab a coffee on the go or to catch up with a friend over lunch or dinner, the Bush Inn Centre is the perfect place. With our unique range of shops, you'll find everything you're looking for and more. Our friendly locals are always happy to help. We have plenty of parking at the Bush Inn Centre, making your shopping experience just a little bit easier. So come in, meet the locals and shop Bush Inn. You'll find us on the corner of Riccarton and Waimari Roads.
Avoid the monkeys when it comes to relocating. Trust A1 Movers, a family business since 1993 that guarantees a professional job every time. We carefully handle and wrap your valued items, ensuring they have a safe journey. Secure storage and insurance options are also available.
A1 Movers, the careful, caring moving company.
Oi!
Let's face it, everyone has an agenda. And guess what? So do I. Every week, I'll pick three stories that grab my attention. Agenda with me, Brent Goff.
Canterbury's rugby union team got off to a flying start in the ITM Cup competition.
It was a game to remember. A win on home turf, Canterbury Rugby beat Auckland 48-9 last Saturday night. Kick-starting their first match of the ITM Cup, the boys in red and black are pleased with the win, but cautious the competition is only going to get tougher.
I think we're lucky enough that we've got a few guys that have been around for a few years now that know to keep the boys grounded after a win like that. Obviously we're really pleased with the way we played, but upon review there's still plenty of areas that we can get better, so just about working hard early in the week and trying to set up a good performance on Friday.
After a victorious defeat over Auckland, the Canterbury captain says often early on there can be some upsets or surprises. Acknowledging the Auckland side are a much better team than what they played, everyone will be pushed harder for the second tournament game. Stepping up their play for this Friday's match, Willie Hines says for Canterbury, it's about improvement and showing it out there on the pitch.
I guess just improvement is the big one. Obviously early on in the season, we're still finding our feet a little bit with how we're playing the game. So, there's been some areas that we've addressed during training today, and hopefully the boys have taken that on board and we're just looking to try and get better each week.
The Canterbury captain believes the Waikato side were fairly accurate in their first match against Wellington. Willie Holmes says the team are a young side but full of energy and will definitely bring something fresh to the provincial tournament.
Going through the squad, I don't see a lot of weaknesses in there. Obviously they do have a young 10, 12, 13, but they played bloody well against Wellington the other night, and we all know Wellington are a pretty good side as well. So Damien McKenzie's got sort of every trick in the book watching him play the other night. We're going to really have our hands full, and I suppose if we can just hold on to the ball as much as we can and just trust our systems, then we'll give ourselves a good chance.
Canterbury's head coach Scott Robertson says Waikato have chosen their squad well and it'll be a game definitely worth watching.
Waikato, they've showed that they've recruited well and they've got some young exciting talent and they're going to be tough, very tough.
And where he believes the Canterbury side can step it up.
Oh, for us, probably a little bit of execution stuff around at our school level when we had opportunities to probably get them on the edge, and we didn't quite execute that, and we spent a lot of time on making sure our shape's right so that we can continue to take those opportunities.
Working hard to defend that National Provincial Rugby Championship title, the boys in red and black will keep trucking on. Joe Albertista, CTV News.
Well, to mark the halfway point of road repairs in Christchurch, we've decided to replay our popular mockumentary on the life cycle of a road cone. Now, online, this video has amassed more than 24,000 views, including from viewers as far away as places like Italy, India and Iceland, where they don't necessarily speak the same language. Here it is again for your enjoyment.
Road cones have been seen in Christchurch for a very long time. No one knows when they first appeared, however, there are no known sightings of them before European settlement. The natural habitat of the road cone is dry, gravelly soil. They tend to be social and prefer to live in large colonies. However, solitary cones are not uncommon. The road cone's main predator is the University of Canterbury student. In Christchurch, after the earthquakes of 2010 and 2011, the number of predators declined. The amount of dry, sandy, and gravelly soils increased, leading to an explosion of the road cone population. We see here a Fulton Hogan cone left behind when the others migrated. It is likely that because of its age, it couldn't keep up with the rest of the group. It faces an uncertain future. Road cones like to disguise themselves as garden sculptures or wear flowers in their tops. Once thought to be prolific, the numbers of cones are rapidly diminishing. Over 25,000 disappeared from the streets and paths of Christchurch in the last year. there are fears now that this proud and noble species may face extinction by 2016.
And wouldn't that be sad? Time now to check out your regional weather.
Good evening, Canterbury. Let's take a look at the region's weather. First in Timaru, Tomoka and Geraldine, a high of 13. Methven and Ashburton had a mild day, hitting 13. Darfield, 13. Leeston and Ralston were slightly cooler on 11. In Lincoln and Christchurch, slightly cooler on 11. To the east in Akarawa, they hit 12 today. Looking now at the Waimakariri, it's 12 degrees in Rangiora, Kaipui and Amberley. Further north in Hanmer Springs, Culverton and Cheviot, they had one of the highs on 13, and up the very top in Kaikoura, 13 degrees. But what's in store for tomorrow? In Timaru, cloudy and cold, with gusty southwesterlies and a few sleety showers, hitting an overnight low of 4 and a high of 8 degrees. In Ashburton, a chilly raw day ahead with overcast skies and sleety showers. Do expect snow below 200 metres at times during the afternoon, hitting an overnight low of 4 and a high of 8 degrees. Christchurch, gusty southwesterlies and sleety showers all day for the city, with very cold temperatures expected, hitting an overnight low of 4, tomorrow's high 8 degrees. And up the top in Kaikoura, cloudy with areas of rain all day, expect fresh southeasterly winds, hitting 4 overnight and a high of 8 degrees. And in other areas around the region, Tomoka and Geraldine a high of 7 and low of 4, Methven and Rakaia snow showers developing in the afternoon with a high of 7 and 8. Starfield, Leeston, Ralston and Lincoln, showers throughout the day with a high of 9. Akarawa, showers with a high of 9. Rangiora, Kaipui and Amberley, showers all day with a high of 8. Hanmer Springs and Culverton, snow showers in the afternoon with a high of 8. And looking ahead for what's in store for the rest of Canterbury. Becoming very cold on Thursday, with cloudy skies and light sleety showers all day. Snow flurries expected to low levels as well. Southwesterly winds becoming fresh and gusty. Cloudy at first on Friday, but a few sunny periods developing during the afternoon. Becoming cold with moderate southerly or southwesterly winds. Similar weather on Saturday, mostly fine and sunny on Sunday and Monday, with frosts morning and night and light winds. And that's all for your region's weather.
And that's CTV News. I'm Grant Mangan. Good night.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.